I'm Kathy Timpey with the New Hanover County Health Department. I'm here today with Dr. Jung Kim. He's with the North Carolina Department of Agriculture and Consumer Services, Structural Pest Control and Pesticides Division. He's an environmental senior specialist in the sleep products section. And he's here today with us to talk about bed bugs. First thing we want to know is, what are bed bugs and what do they look like?
Bed bugs are as big as apple seed. They are usually brown when they fully grown. Immatures can be yellow or white or red when they feed on blood. And the eggs are elongated shape, 1 or 2 millimeter. But eggs are sticky. So when they lay eggs, they put their eggs cemented on the surface. So you cannot use a vacuum machine to remove eggs. When you do the thorough treatment, make sure that you address the issue with the eggs.
I see. Now, a lot of people are asking, why are bed bugs so common today? Why have they made a resurgence in this country?
Well, the big main reason why they came back is the travelers, increasing travels. The people from U.S. go to the third world, and people in the third world come visit the United States. Sometimes they bring bed bugs with them. So that's why we started seeing the bed bug infestation in the travel industry. And also another reason why we have a bed bug resurgence is bed bugs have developed insecticide resistance to the chemical we use nowadays. So it can be challenging if you only use a chemical, might be easy to eradicate all the bed bugs in your home.
I see. Well, the public also needs to know if bed bugs can carry disease.
They are not a vector, so that means they cannot transmit any disease. Mm-hmm. But if you analyze bed bugs, they do have some human pathogen on their body. But again, they are not a vector, they cannot transmit any disease.
But they can cause health problems.
Right, they can cause a lot of health problems. The main thing is excessive itchiness. Their bites are very itchy. You scratch a lot, that causes a secondary infection. Mm-hmm. People lose sleep, and sometimes, you know, young or elderly can develop anemia. And also the emotional stress is a major thing, that people can be socially isolated. If you have bed bugs, if I have bed bugs, I'm not going to visit my friends or relatives. I'm not going to invite them either. So you can be socially isolated. It can be emotionally very stressful.
Yes, I can see that. So what should people do when they're traveling to protect themselves from bed bugs?
Before you travel, you have to be prepared, know about bed bugs. When you go into the hotel room or area that you're going to stay, do the inspection. If you do very thorough visual inspection, then you can be sure that, you know, you are bed bug free. The way you do inspection is to look for the mattress and box spring, look for the areas and headboard and bed frame, and you look for signs of infestation. Those are the eggs and the live or dead bed bugs or fecal material. Those fecal materials are bloodstained. What bed bugs do is they feed on you and excrete some of your blood as a fecal material. That leaves a black dots around their hiding places. Mm. So when you do the inspection, look for those signs of infestation. If you don't find any, then you can stay in the room. If you find some, then you better ask the manager that you want to move into the new room,
sure,
hopefully far away from the room that you found some infestation.
Yes, that's good advice. Now, what if you are not sure or you didn't take precautions and you get home after a trip and you think that maybe you brought them home with you? What should you do then?
Right, so if you have a good reason to believe that you may brought bed bugs with you, or you have some bed bug bites while you're traveling, one thing you can do is all the washable item, you can put it into the laundry dryer, set it at the high heat setting, run it about 30 minutes, mm-hmm, and any bed bugs like eggs, nymphs, or adults will die in that dryer. So it's a very good way to treat your washable item. For your luggage, you can isolate that luggage in the garage or somewhere, or maybe put some plastic cover over it so you can, you know, be assured that the bed bugs cannot come into your house. And bed bugs can live about 3 months without blood feeding. They can even live up to 6 months if the temperature is cold. So when you isolate your luggage and you may have some suspicion, it may have some bed bugs on them, just store them for like 6 months. And then, you know, bed bugs in that luggage, might be in that luggage, die because of starvation.
Okay. Well, what about chemical treatment? Do you recommend that?
Chemical treatments is part of IPM, the Integrated Pest Management. So chemical should be effective if the bed bug population are sensitive to the chemical. But however, we know the majority of population in the United States already have developed some resistance to the chemical we use. So what you have to do is you have to combine multiple methods. So chemical is only part of it, but you want to add the steam treatment, dry heat, and the encasement, and plastic covers, and physical removal. So all those methods should be combined together to effectively eradicate all the bed bugs. I mean, how many bed bugs are too many? So one single bed bug are too many. Mm-hmm. One fragrant female bed bug coming into your home, the number can be grow to the 500 in 3 months, and that number will grow to 31,700 in 6 months. So the key is early detection, and you want to eradicate all the bed bugs you have in your home.
Wow, that's some really good information. Now, I know a lot of people buy used furniture and used mattresses. Is that a practice that you would say that people should be careful with?
Well, the answer for that, I will say yes and no. If you know what you're doing, and if you look for, if you can recognize the signs of bed bug infestation, yes, you can buy those furniture. But if you don't know what you are doing, and if you're afraid of getting bed bugs, I recommend not to. So it depends on your experience, depends on your knowledge on bed bugs. You can do it or you may not do it.
What about used mattresses for resale? Are they safe?
For the used mattresses for resale, should have a yellow tax on them. The state licensed sanitizer, they sanitize the mattress for resale and they put the yellow tax on them. So you should check for the yellow tax for the used mattress. Okay. Check for the white tax for brand new mattress. But always good to inspect the mattress and box spring whether you can detect any signs of infestation. Again, black fecal material is very easy to recognize. So look for those signs of infestation.
I see. So how about demonstrating for us how you would do an inspection?
Oh, sure. Let's head in. The first thing I usually do is I check the material, what kind of material the headboard or bed frame made of. Mm-hmm. If it's a metal, it will just reduce the chance that it may get some bed bugs on them. Bed bugs do prefer living the wood material or papers. And when since it is a metal frame, I'm not gonna look into the headboard. I'm gonna check on the corner and the top corner, and then I'm gonna inspect the bottom corner. Bed bugs are drawn into your body heat and CO2 breathing, so they probably tend to gather on the top upper part or top part of mattress. And then here, checking on that and see whether you can detect any signs of infestation. I'm gonna inspect the bottom part and pull it out, and then inspect whether you can see any signs of infestation.
So you're looking inside the seam there.
Right, this one has an encasement. Encasement is a great thing. It has a nice zipper. What it does is encasements protect the mattress and box spring. When you get them, please get as a set, get the encasements for mattress, and then also get an encasement for box spring. If you have an infestation or bed bugs, they probably living in one of these two items. So get that encasement and cover it, and that's protecting your mattress and box spring. And when you have an infestation, like a future infestation, bed bugs probably living in on the outside of the encasement, and that makes you easy to detect bed bugs if you have any new infestation. But okay. In this case, I did not detect any signs of infestation. I don't find any black fecal material or live or dead bed bugs, and no shed skin. So this mattress and mattress encasements are very clean, okay. And I'm pleased to see that.
Now, do you also look at the bed frame and the baseboards?
What's going to happen is if you have a heavy infestation, let's say they didn't have encasements and they have some infestation, probably 70 or 80% probably living in the box spring, and you don't really see that much of a black fecal material, that you may overlook that. And one other area you can look at is you can look at the baseboard. So if you look at the baseboard, if they are living in the baseboard, they will leave a black fecal material on the around the edge of that baseboard. That's how you detect bed bug infestation. One other area you want to look into is a hanging picture frame. If you have bed bug infestation, you may see some black spots around this picture frame, or maybe on the paper cover on the backside of the picture.
Okay.
So that's where you want to look. But mm-hmm. usually, if you didn't find anything in this mattress and box spring and top corner, if you have a wood bed headboard, make sure that you check the backside of it, because that's the place that you always have to check. Mm-hmm. And didn't find anything, then it is safe for you to stay in this room. But if you have find any signs of infestation or live bed bugs, maybe not good idea to stay in here. So you want to ask your manager or front desk that you want to move into the new room, maybe away from this room.
Far away.
Yeah, far away.
Well, that's very good information, Dr. Kim.
You're welcome.
Thank you so much.